FMTG here, and we've got another match of our Exelon Sealed League! And we are going to mulligan because having one thing to do at four is not what I would like to see. Ah! Yes, I think I will keep this even though technically I don't have anything to do till four, but I have a commune with dinosaurs and we will put that on top of my library. At least we'll know for sure we'll hit. Do you only get to put one, put the rest on the bottom in any order, so do we take the chance? I don't have anything to do on two, so I think we'll just pass as I go. Maybe we can see what we're playing against too. That'll be fun, because I really want to draw that Ripjaw. I really want that Ripjaw Raptor in my hand. Actually, no, I lied. I want it on the battlefield being hit, so I can draw cards with it, because... Happy day! Yeah. Alright, let's see what our other hits would have been. Land. See? I'm glad I didn't, because I do want, I think we want that, and that, and that, and we don't really want that. It's a fun card to see and if things will work, but really, I don't think I'm ever gonna actually want to play that card. I'm just saying. Oh, Drover the Mighty. Good early, decent late. I drew my other one. But to be fair, this is not the worst thing I could do. To be fair, we are getting things. We're going through a lot of lands, so that's what we really want to see, probably. Yeah, I'm gonna get out round. To be fair, I'm gonna get a Ripjaw Raptor out next turn, and I'm going to party. Technically, they could get a Ripjaw Raptor out this turn, and they could party. But what are the odds of them also having a Ripjaw Raptor? Not that high. But, I mean, there is a possibility. Six packs, one rare in each pack. I don't know what percentage a Ripjaw Raptor is, and I mean, the chances are there is a possibility. Or you could just have a captivating crew. I don't like that. I don't like that one bit. Can I even play things now? Cause it's just gonna get taken over. Pay four, capture the Ripjaw, attack for eight. You don't have to do anything else this turn. Okay, if I have any pounces, or if I have any of my lightning strikes, I can get through this. Those are the two cards I am wanting to draw right now. And I know I have at least one lightning strike in there. I think I have two pounces in there. So... Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm not gonna trade. It would be a fair trade. And I could draw a card off of it. You probably have something awful. Okay, good. I got another forest out of my hand. So the good news is we can grazing whiptail. And we don't get it taken away from us. I'm having a party over here. I drew a card off of Ripjaw Raptor. I can check that one off my to-do list. I would think next time is to get drew cards off of Ripjaw Raptor. Alright, you've got a lot of mana there, so you have a Sunbird's Evocation. Giggle, giggle, giggle. This is gonna be great. I get to explore. I'd rather see not that. Yep, go attack. I'm excited to see where their deck is going with the Sunbird Evocation. Oh, they don't know I have that card, do they? Okay. What do you get cast for free? Emergent Growth? That's all you get. It must be blocked if able. That is really rude. Pouncity, 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 pounce. Ooh, no, 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 cancel it. I don't want to play that yet. I mean, I do want to play it. But the question is... Okay, so we could... do this. Get it right this time and pounce. Creature you control, target creature they control, pay two, pounce. Okay, go to combat, I'll attack. Boom. That's it, that's my turn. Pretty sure I already played a land this turn. Pretty sure. How does that work? Whenever you cast a spell. Yep, okay. What do you get for three? You can get a Tishana's Wayfinder or a Rivered Herald's Boon. You can go with the Tishana's Wayfinder, right? Because at this point, it looks like they probably need more creatures. Okay. That's nice. And you get the double bonus. Man, you got nice, nice draw there. Alright, 1, 2. Alright. Let's see what you get for 2. Forest? I don't think you get to do a forest. Cool. I have a target, Lower Folk. Let's put it there. Alright, go grazing, Whiptail. Okay. We could get rid of you later. I think we want the 4/4 out, or we could. Okay, so we're only getting to kill one creature. Yeah, let's do that. Seems fine. Okay. I guess you don't have any, yep, okay. Okay, pounce. What can we get rid of? Nothing great. One, two, three, four, five. So we can get rid of that. I think we do. Okay. Attacking creatures get +2/+0 until end of turn. That's any attacking creatures, right? Okay, well, we're gonna try it and see what happens because if I read that right, it says attacking creatures get +2/+0 until end of turn. That did not work. Attacking creatures get +2/+0 until end of turn. I guess they have to be attacking when it's cast. Oh. Well, not stupid. Oh well. What I get for taking risks and not knowing what the car is doing. Oh, and taking 6 damage. Sounds good. 6 or 3? Just 3. Alright. I'm gonna be taking 6 to the face later. Oh, and a raging cyborg truth. Oh, goodbye, Drover of the Mighty. Yes. Right? No, because it's on the battlefield. They also have a Ripjaw Raptor. So, there's that. Tons of lands to the bottom, and I feel like I've drawn a lot. Okay. Both. Only one has trample. still took a lot. And I don't think I can live through this turn. I blocked a 6, I still take 5, and if they attack with everything, I'm dead. Alright. Okay. I still gotta play Ripjaw Raptor and draw a card off of it, so I'm doing really good today. Sunbird's Invocation. Yeah, play Swashbuckling. What do you get? +2/+2 and has haste? You should have put. Oh, because it wasn't on the battlefield yet. Oh, yeah, go for it. Taking 7. Even if I block there, and then I'm taking you. Okay, just attack with everything, and don't be dumb. Uh huh. Or just attack with those two. Yeah, there you go. Alright. Boop. Boop. Alright, let's sideboard. Yeah. Okay, let's mix it up. I thought we took this card out. I thought we did. I think we take this out and we put the pounce back in. With that deck. Let's do this one. Yes, I would love to play first. I always like playing first, generally speaking. Okay, we've got stuff to do. No, we don't have Charter Curse, but that's okay. No possible play, please yield. Oh. Get Wild Growth, walk around. If we could draw another land, we could find Ship Mystic Dude. Eventually get up to our Cyteratops or our Colossal Dreadmaw. That's what we really want. Cause 6/6 trample for 6. That's fine. Uh-oh. This is a problem. Duh, shoot! I pushed the wrong button. It did not say attack with all, that said okay. That's fine. Stuck anyway. Ah. Go 2/4. Hey, you got a Ripjaw Raptor. Hey, do I have a way to take care of that? No. No. Good news though, I can play out my Grazing Whiptail. Bad news though, I'm just going to pass the turn. Well, I loved you. That's fine. Yeah, go for your Sunbird's Invocation. I'll get F5 so I could get something else to S3, but I could also play a chart, a course, and give someone a +1/+1 counter. Yeah! This one. Let's give that to you. Make you a nice big 5/5. Okay. Attack, attack, attack. And we get to draw 2 cards this turn, too. Oh my goodness, this is so exciting. Boom. Alright, let's pick a move. We will take an island. Let's put this one, and this one, and this one, this one. I land for the turn. I still have that! Beautiful. I'm happy. Ooh, and I have enough to play Colossal Red Mob next turn. And I think I have enough to keep 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have enough to keep up Dive Down 2 on my Colossal Dreadmaw. I can protect against those white removal spells that my opponent doesn't have because they are playing green and red. And I have not seen another color. So there's that. Alright, you're playing 3 mana. What do you get? 3 more cards. Enter the battlefield of the revealed stone mountain. Merchant growth. Cover the mighty. Seems good. Plus, you have a dinosaur, so you get to, do that. That's cool. Ah, yes. Yeah, throw that on your Ripjaw Raptor. Seems like a good idea. Alright, now you have like 5 mana. Or you could play Deshano's Wayfinder. And I guess you could play River Herald's Boon, right? That's what you gotta go with? Which seems fine. You gotta put another +1/+1 counter on the Ripjaw, or you could put one on the Drover. And you gotta put one on the other Deshano's Wayfinder. Okay. Did you not get both? I don't think they got both. Or maybe they did both. I am not even mountain. Okay. That's fine. I mean, why would you not hit for 5? Oh, because I'm gonna kill you. Ooh, I see. I mean, you could hit for 5. Okay. Well, first off, had to. Thank you. We're just gonna get all ginormous up in here. Profit bot. Okay. We just leave it as is. And push okay. Okay, and if we draw a land, that's good. We can get both of those down next turn, which seems nice. And if we don't draw a land, we draw something else, which also seems good. Yeah, that seems bad. It's a lot of mana. I believe that I don't care what happens in this game. I got to play 1, 2, 3 dinosaurs plus a Ripjaw Raptor. I'm super excited. So, yeah. Ancient Brabantodon. Okay. I think you gotta hit something. What are you gonna play? Captivating thing? You could play Swashbuckling and give it haste. That could be. Alright, you could play that. Or you could play that. I mean, Raging Swordtooth seems. Yeah, trigger Ripjaw Raptor. That seems a good idea. Good. Yeah, that seems like what you would potentially want to do. I don't know what else they've got. Raging Swords 2, Swashbuckling, give that a tramp. 2+2+2 and trample. And haste, so it'd be an 11-11. And then you swing something chumps there. I mean, yeah, with that. I mean, Raging Sword 2 seems like a great idea. You get a 5/5 body with trample, and you do 1 damage to each other creature you have out on the battlefield, which includes a Ripjaw Raptor, so you're drawing a card. Although, to be fair, Cap Decorating Crew also seems like a really good idea. Then you can try and take over my stuff, but see, then I path my deck down and make it hexproof, so you can't target it. But it only worked once. Yeah, you have the Raging Swordtooth, yeah. Seems fair. That deals 1 damage to me. So if I had had a Ripjaw Raptor out, I would have gotten to also draw a card. But guess what's in my hand and not on the battlefield, because you know that would be too convenient. Okay, Sunbird's Invocation, if you can get it out and have expensive things to play, seems fine. It seems very good. Alright. Hello, Stalemate, and me playing Fairy Magic and playing one thing a turn. Okay. We get to tap something down, and it doesn't untap on their untap step. Okay, we could do Ancient Brabantodon. That means I probably won't die. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and then we have 4, so we can get the Ripjaw Raptor out. We don't have any protection from anything else. But let's go push okay. Okay, no decks. Alright. Give me all blues. Boop, boop. Boop. Okay, Brontodon, stay down. Okay. And Ripjaw Raptor. Go. Go, my Ripjaw Raptor, go. You are mightily outclassed on the other side, but you are here, and you are here to join the party, and hopefully draw me at least 1 card, because that would be awesome. That would be great. Burning Sun's Avatar. I don't have anything that's 3 mana, but I do have my Water Trap Raider, so that's gonna leave. Probably. And whatever else awfulness, you know, you get from your, see what you pick. I mean, Ravenous Daggertooth. Well, New Horizons, that seems. Yeah. Yeah, put it on there, make it bigger than my 6x over here. That makes total sense. Deal 3 damage. You could honestly deal enraged damage to that, which would be... But yeah, you're going to get rid of that. I'm going to take 3 to the face. And sunburn implication has caused this tide to kind of turn in the wrong direction for me. It's the right direction for you. Doing really good. Alright, emergent growth. Yeah, you can't do that. I mean, you attack with some big stuff, right? Nope. Okay. Sure. Probably just waiting to... 9 attacking. I should probably have gone with the Riptide Raptor just to drag card. Even though it wouldn't have done anything, because you would have just blocked it, put a counter on that, put a counter on it, yep. Put another counter on it. Okay, that guy has trample. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you put another counter on that. Alright. Okay. I think we go for the rip draw. We'll get a draw card. Very least, possibly save it with dive down and draw a card. Okay, so I'm not gonna live. Alright, we definitely want to do that. And we do not want to hit the Riptide Raptor over there. I still get to draw a card. Okay. I can really mess things up now. And since I can mess them up, and I probably also will mess up at some point. Alright, put a counter. Put a counter. Let me guess. One more time? Sure. It's fine. Okay. It's fine. Let's figure this out. I can only get rid of one thing. Right. All right, you block here. Okay. not so. Oh, that is not at all what I wanted to see. Lol. Great. Okay. Spot there, see if we can get that to pull off the board, and throw you in that direction. Alright, what offer must you get? Oh yeah, I'm gonna lose my Colossal Dreadmaw. That's super sad. Sorry, Colossal Dreadmaw. I don't think I stand a chance, especially now with Captivating Groove on the table, because that means they take something over. How many times do you have to do that? Yeah, you get another creature, that's great. It gains haste, activate this ability only. Okay, but if you have enough mana, from what it sounds like, you can do that as many times as you want. Okay. Definitely passing. Alright, let's see what happens, because they should have enough mana to do this at least like twice. Like a lot of times. A lot of times. Uh-huh. Oh, he only took the one? Okay, if you don't say, I'll attack. Trample, trample, so you come through here. Wait, chump block here. Get five there. Yeah, so, okay, that's fine. I don't have a way to win, so let's just call it like I see it and say GG, that was a good game, but that board state was not great for me. So yeah, leave all my mistakes in the comments below, like this video, and subscribe for more.